Hey, what's up, guys? If you're working with Windows 11 and unknowingly you have installed a lot of languages and keyboards in your computer, and you can see that you possibly have 5-6 languages on your in your taskbar, and every time you need to switch, it's a hassle to go through all 5 or 6 different languages to select your language which you want to work on. So in this video, I will show you 3 simple and easy working solutions to get rid of all these additional languages and additional keyboards from your system. My name is Mazhar, and at RightSolutions, I create tutorials for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's head to the system and remove these languages from your taskbar. So here you can see in my system, I got about 5 languages, English, Canada, English, US, and Urdu, Pakistan, and then again Urdu, Pakistan, which is actually Arabic keyboard 1 or 2. And then again, there is a Urdu phonetic version 1.1. So let's go and remove a few languages from the system here, and we'll remove this Arabic and Urdu, Pakistan. So let's head to the search button here, and just click on this button and type settings. So this setting app comes up here, and just click on this app to open it up. And now you can see that this app has actually 2 different sections. So the language section on the top here is the place where you can add and remove languages. Any additional language you want to add, you can just add from there, or maybe you want to remove, you can remove from there. And there's the second part, which is the region. So to change the setting, first thing, let's go and look on the left side here and click on the time and language option here. And it will bring up for this time and language settings for you. So go and click on to the language and region and click on this button here, and it will open up all these languages which are installed. So this is almost the same previous menu, but I just wanted you to navigate from the original place where it comes from. Go and select this Urdu language pack, which is the one we are going to remove some languages. So click on this language option here, and now you can see that this is the language which we are going to keep, and now we'll remove this one. So just click on this menu here and remove. And then again, look for the this Arabic 1 or 2 language and just click on the button here and click on remove. And now you can see this these 2 additional languages are gone. So now we are remaining with this Urdu phonetic keyboard here. So let's close it here, and now you can just click on this languages here, and now you can see we are only left with this 3 languages, which is English Canada, English United States, and Urdu phonetic keyboard here. So this was the first solution. Let's head to the solution number 2 now. Let's continue from the same where we left. So we got these 3 languages, so we will just remove one of these languages from here. The solution which I'm going to show, this will most probably work with all the previous version of the Windows as well. And this is possibly the most easiest and simple solution to get rid of the languages which are stubborn sometimes, that they don't appear in your language settings. So now this time, let's just click on this more keyboard settings here to open up the same setting page here. So now, if you can just see that these are the languages, English Canada, we are going to remove temporarily. I will bring it back, and we will keep, for the time being, we'll keep these 2 languages, Urdu and English United States. So for doing so, just go back, close this one here, and go back to the search here. And now at this search bar here, just simply type PowerShell. So normally you need this window PowerShell. But when you type PowerShell, so you will see that here you can see this option had come up, and you can just right click on it and run as an administrator. So just select it, and here we are. So now you can just let's go and maximize it here, and now let's see, you can see that this cursor here. So just at this place, before we actually decide to remove the languages, let's see what languages are installed here. So just on this blinking cursor, just type get dash win user language list and hit enter, and it will load all the languages which are installed in your system. So you can see that we had these 3 languages, English Canada, English US, and URPK. So what are we going to do is we will just remove this English Canada, and we will keep this bottom 2 languages, US English and URPK. So to do so, just come back here on the blinking cursor. So type here set dash win user language list and give a space. And now for the language which you want to keep, this is the language tag. So we are going to keep this second one here. So EN-US, type as it is. So en-us in caps, and put a comma again for the second language and give a space. And now type the language tag again, ur-pk in caps. And now when you hit enter, you will see that you will prompt with the options. To confirm with this operation, click yes, or you say no, or you can even suspend these languages, but we don't want to. We want to remove the third language, so we'll just say yes with the operation here. So type y and enter. And now you can see that you got two warning messages. It says the warning: if window display language has changed, it will take effect after the next sign-in. So you got two messages because we kept two languages. So even if your language did not change or did not disappeared, if you restart the system, it will take an effect. So now let's go click on the languages here, and you can just see that English US is remaining, and Urdu PK is remaining. The Canada English language has been removed. So that's it. It's a working solution. So it is very simple, very easy, and you don't have any risk to get into any trouble. So just close it here, and now just restart the system if you think that is still language is not gone. Let's head to the solution number 3 now. So this time we are going to use registry editor. And mind you, try to avoid that one if you are not really sure what you're doing, because it might will mess up your registry if you make a mistake. But if you just follow what I'm going to do here, it's very simple. It should not be a problem. So just type here registry, just type R-E-E-G, and you will just see the app is coming up. So just this app, registry editor, right click on this registry editor and run as an administrator. And this is the registry editor had open up in front of you. So let's, before we do anything, it's always good to take a backup. So just click on export here, and just wherever you want to save, just type any name, just say backed up one, and just simply save it here. So in case you have a problem, you can just come and restore here. So now after taking the backup, just go into the second option here, H key current user, just click on this arrow to open up this menu, and then just go look for the keyboard layouts. And now in keyboard layout, select preload and right click on it and just simply delete this one and confirm it. Okay. Now close this one up, and now go again to H key users and click on default here and just look for the keyboard layout again and click it here and look for the preload option and just go right click and just delete it like other you did. So now of course this is all gone, so just close it up, and now your taskbar must be cleaned up, and if it did not, you have to restart your computer to just take this in effect. So I hope these solutions worked for you. If any of this solution had worked for you, don't forget to thumbs me up, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you with next video. You have a wonderful day.